Come gather round and I will tell of a battle fought long ago. Up in the hills above Lake George, amidst the carnage and the snow. It was in March of 58, from Fort Edward Rogers came with his rangers up the lake. All of New France trembled at his name as Rogers trudged through the drifting snow. Fort William Henry's blackened shell loomed above him with its ghost, and he swore to avenge them well. And from the fort called Carillon, a partisan who was named Langy, under the Marquis de Montcalm, fought for France neath the fleur-de-lis. As long she sat by the barracks fire, safe from the grip of the awful cold, an Indian scout that the French had hired, old tales of Rogers' attacks he told. But as he looked deep into the fire, Langy could picture Quebec ablaze, and it became his one desire to see Rogers laid in his grave. And as the French laughed and drank their tea, a runner came through the fortress gate. Rogers' rangers had just been seen on the trail leading to the lake. With that the Abenaki cried, volunteers ran for knife and gun. Toward the lake the men did fly, into the glow of the setting sun. To one young soldier said Langy, lead them to where the brook does wind. I will assemble the marines and follow quickly from behind. But Rogers' scouts watched atop the hill. Back to their captain they did go, and Rogers laid a cunning trap, his marksman buried beneath the snow. When that young Frenchman reached the bend, his Indian scout froze at his side. The volley echoed across the wind. They fell like wheat before the scythe. A quarter mile back on the trail. Longy heard the muskets roar. Up to the heavens he did wail. As off toward the brook he tore. How he ran like a man possessed. On his snowshoes toward the fight. While the spruce trees cut his breast. Running toward the fading light. His men fanned out across the woods. Running silent they did go. While Roger's men took guns and goods. From their victims there in the snow. And when the French finally reached the rise and came bursting through the trees, Rogers looked up in blank surprise. By God, I've got you, screamed Longy. From Longy then they did levy an awful toll. Rogers fell back with half his men. The other half lay dead in the snow. Longy orders his men to hold. As he called out in the fading light, only a madman or a fool tracks wounded bears through the dark of night. Gather round and I will tell of these brave soldiers and their deeds. Not just of Rogers and his men, but of that brave son of France, Longy.